So if you unpack the Quick Buttons archive, this is what you see. And this is Quick Buttons. This is the button bar. So if you start it, the first thing you will see is that it will start Blender for you. And the reason for that is here the Quick Button code. You can see it will find out how you will start a blend file, and then it will use the path blend files are registered and add a command line parameter to Blender so that you get the system console immediately. So and it will do one more thing. You may see that sometimes Blender opens too small or too large, and once Quick Button starts, it will restore Blender to the size that you have selected. And this is simply done by this button, Save Restore Blender. You give Blender the size that you want and you press the left button, Save, and then Quick Buttons will automatically give Blender exactly that size that you have saved. Also, if Blender is somewhere else or has the wrong size, you just press the right button here, Restore Blender, and it will give Blender window the size that that you want. So that's the first thing that you see when you start Quick Buttons. So actually I'm doing some changes in the structure of the add-on, so you can take a look on the developer's desk. So then let's test it, pressing the rerun button. Of course it will restore the Blender window, which I don't want now, so I will move it a bit here, and we have it. So you see when I'm moving the mouse over the add-on, the code on the right side is displaying in real time what's happening. This is the Smart Package Robot script. So let's take a quick look what's in the box. When you unpack the Quick Buttons file, this is what you get. And this folder you can copy wherever you like. The only thing is it must stay all together. And because these files work together, so just leave them in this folder. Means you need here the library in the same folder like the quickbuttons.exe. And also you need the button files. You see here BE1 to BE7. These are the button definitions for Quick Buttons. So if you open it, you will see here, this is the button text, and here is the tooltip text, and this is what the button is doing if you press the left mouse button or if you press the right mouse button. So this is are all text files. And also this means if I rename BE1 to BE7 and BE7 to BE1, I have just exchanged the layers. So it's that easy. If you have made changes to the buttons or button layers and you want to have the original version, here is the button backup.zip file. It contains a backup from the button files in the original state. So then we have a cleanup executable. This will delete all versions of Quick Buttons. You will say, why would I run more than one version of Quick Buttons? The point is, you also have this desktop manager exe. I will show you mine. And here you have as many desktops as you like. You can just create a new desktop by pressing here on new desktop. And on any of the desktop, you can have one version Blender running with the quick buttons attached to it. So you can have multiple versions running. If you want to switch to that desktop, you just select it here in the list and you press switch to selected. Please make sure that on the other desktop, that you create desktop with Explorer, and on the other desktop you have the option to go back to this desktop. In this, and you also see here, if you are on the default desktop like now, you see it here. If you are on another desktop, you see it also here. You also have options to see the windows on other desktops here. For example, if I want to see what's on desktop 2, I can select desktop 2 and go here, and I see on desktop 2 there is something. And okay, that's the desktops manager. This helps you if you want to work with multiple versions of Blender and you don't want to have them all on the same desktop. So then we have the manual. This is a PDF file here. This is a manual which describes most of the buttons in detail and also what you can do with quick buttons. Here is the download exe. If you start it, nothing will happen at first. I can start it, so you see. So nothing happens. So what happens will take a while, because this program is now downloading a 50 megabyte zip file. Exactly the zip file that you have already, but the newest update. You see here it appears, and you see the changing date is today, and it contains the newest version of quick buttons. So because we have the newest version, I can delete it. Then you have the button mover. So now let's start quick buttons, that you see what it's good for and where the other stuff is good for. So I just start quick buttons, and quick buttons will now do the following. It will check which Blender version that you have installed is registered if you click a normal Blender file. And it will exactly start this version of Blender. And it will do a little bit more. It will also resize Blender, you see here. So I need only one. So it will also resize Blender. And now the question is, what size will it give the Blender window? That's up to you. You just give Blender the size you like. Then you click here on Save button. And then the next time you start Blender using quick buttons, you will have two advantages. First, you will always get the Blender system console immediately. And secondly, quick buttons will give Blender this size. Also for example, if I make Blender now smaller and I click Restore Blender, this is the right mouse button, then I will get the Blender window to the size that I want back. So this is button 21 in layer 1, is for just saving and restoring the size of the Blender window from whatever. So now you see quick buttons here. You will say, oh, it uses a lot of time. No problem, you can press the hide button. This is this button, and if you press the left button here, it will just get very small until you move the mouse over it, then you have your buttons back. So there is one thing you need to know, and that is, before you can use quick buttons together with Blender, you must inform Blender about quick buttons and your library. And this is done with a simple click on button 20. So the first thing you should always do is click button 20. And what you also see now is quick buttons needs this console window, this Blender console window here, down here. And this is something you have to do. So if you don't have it, means if your blender looks like this, you go here, make a horizontal split, move the split down until you have the perfect size, and then you click here and you go on Python console, because this thing here quick buttons needs. And when you have done that, you press button 20. When you take a look on quick buttons, the first thing that you see is the huge button bar with multiple layers, but the core of quick buttons is the library. So here you have the library.py with 226 kilobytes today, and it looks like this. It contains a lot of 6,500 lines of Python code for many aspects of Blender and for all the buttons, so no secrets. And this is the core of quick buttons, is this huge library. And now the point is, what can you do with such an external library? I will show you what you can do with it. For example, I go to layer 1 and now I connect quick buttons with Blender. For this we need the console window down here, and I need to press the left mouse button on button 20. I will do that now. You see something happens here. Quick buttons write something, and it also writes here a pass. And from this moment, Blender is connected with your library pass in quick buttons. This is the library pass here. Is just a side of quick buttons here. And this means that now you can manually or with the buttons now use the library. For example, I can just type here set looks core render. Let me just show you the render. It's more at the moment Eevee. I press enter. And now you see here it's set to looks core. I can say render image, which in fact is a library command. It's here in the library. And you see it's already rendering the image. You don't see anything, of course, but it's rendering the image using looks core this time. Okay, now we have another thing you can do with quick buttons. If you manage, like me, to make Blender, it doesn't really hang, you know, it's busy, but in this case it's even hard to close it here with the close button, because this even will not react. So the alternative is, you have here another button that is kill Blender. Press the right mouse button, you get this one, and you can say okay, and Blender will be shot. So this is another thing, and it will automatically start a new instance of Blender. It will not automatically start a new instance of quick buttons. This we will have to do manually. So I will do that, and we'll start quick buttons. Once Blender is already here, quick buttons will quickly attach to the Blender window. Let me show you why quick buttons is very good for people who want to use Python with Blender. So I press the button 20 that will connect the Blender console with quick buttons, the left mouse button, but this is doing one more thing that's not so openly visible. It will connect the library and the library folder with Blender. So this means you can choose any library sub-program and immediately use it in Blender. So for example, set render cycles, kopieren. I can just paste the command. I need the brackets. So, and then you see the render engine is set to cycles. Or set render Eevee, kopieren. Let's go the other direction. And you see it's Eevee. So you have all the library commands and you can directly use them here in the console window. And this is exactly what QuickButton itself is doing. So for example, I have this floor. I want to add it to a rigid body. So I can just click this button. And in fact, QuickButton will just write this library in here in the window, and this is how it works. And the additional point is you can use and make your own libraries. So this means you can now easily write your own subprograms also in the library, or make your own libraries and import them here on the top, because now the library path is registered with Blender. And this is the point, you have registered the library path with just one click. You click here and your library path is registered with Blender. You can use the library. Let me show you one more simple feature. I have on button layer 7 the option set text editor. If I press this, you will see that the text editor gets here some default Python code.
And then you can copy your own Python code inside whatever, and you can test it.
So now you can easily test your own Python code. Here we have the hello world. And you get, for example, the active object already, or you get the selected objects remembered. You have an override for the 3D view, for example, if you need it for something. So you can more easily test your Python scripts with also just one button click. Here on this is button 9. Now, before we look what functions are already on the buttons, let me show you how you can define your own buttons or redefine buttons that you prefer to have. Even how you can make a new layer with your own functions. So the design of the buttons is very easy. If you go into the Quick Buttons folder, you find these subfolders BE1 to BE7. Let's open BE7, and then you see it has text files, normal text files. They are written button 01 to button 16. Now let's go to layer 7 with a click here on the right mouse button. And you see layer 7 has buttons 1 to 16. So you see a Quick Buttons just reads these text files and makes from each text file exactly one button. This means if I rename this text file from 16 to 1 and I switch them, then this button will go here and this button will go here down. Of course, it's a little bit work to do that. Because of this, we have the switch button exe. With this program, you can switch the buttons. You just start it, tell it the buttons to switch, see the manual, and it will do that for you. Let's go back to the button and take a look inside. This is, for example, button 1, collapse all, slash, expand all. The slash always divides between the left mouse button function and the right mouse button function. So if I press the left mouse button, let me show this to you. If I press the left mouse button, it will collapse all. You see the outliner, everything collapsed. If I press the right mouse button, it will expand all. Just remember all those scenes with a lot of objects and you want to collapse all. It's now just one click. Collapse all, or you can expand it again. So, and this is the definition for the button, looks like this. Here in the first line is the text on the button. Then comes the tooltip text. Left mouse button and right mouse button. Tooltip text. Tooltip is when you drive over the button, you get this tooltip. Here, you don't see it really because the Blender window is too large. Let me make it a bit smaller. Now you can see the tooltip from the button. So you can define the tooltip yourself. The tooltip is also here in the text file. And then immediately after the tooltips comes the text for the left button. This is the text that is written down here. You see it in the console window. And then comes the special tag on right mouse button. This one. So this. And this shows when the code for the right mouse button comes. So this is the code for the right mouse button here. Let's now take a look at the special buttons. These buttons you cannot change. They are system buttons. And these are mostly these two layer switching buttons here on top. And these buttons, they are specially made that you can get to any layer quickly. So actually we are on layer 1, you see that here, because the 1 is in the brackets. And we can go to layer 2, to layer 4, to layer 6, or to layer 7, just with one click on the left or on the right mouse button. We cannot go to all layers because it's 7 layers and we have only 2 buttons. So to get to layer 3, you will have to click 2 times. So, but you can reach any layer with at most 2 clicks. And that's the system behind these buttons. These buttons have an algorithm that will have you reach any layer for 10 layers with just at most 2 clicks, but mostly with 1 click. So you quickly get where you need. There is one exception. For example, if I am on layer 1, now I'm on layer 1, and I go to layer 4. Now from layer 4, I have no way back to layer 1. So we have an additional button now here. This is the end button. And if you click right button on layer on the end button, it's a back button. You get to go to the layer where you have been before. So you see, it's always switching between 1 and 4. So this is new. You can also go just back to the layer where you was. There are some reasons for this, which have to do with the functions on layer 4, and you need functions on layer 1. So there are more special buttons on layer 1. Let's go on layer 1. So first, of course, the add library button, reset Python button. The reset Python, it does something, but it does not what it should. If you get error messages like this, possibly you forgot to press the left button on add library, because then the name is not defined. So add library, and now you can reset Python. So, but add library. So this is the most important button. It will connect quick buttons, and especially the library folder here will connect the library folder with the search path from Blender Python. And this gives you the possibility to have all your own libraries also in this folder and just import them. And this with one click. So then we have the Save Restore Blender button. If I click this Restore Blender right button, you see Blender will immediately get to the window size that I have previously saved it, and it will also exactly get the position, window position. So this is the Save Restore button. You choose the size and position you like, and then you press Save, and then quick button will try to bring your Blender into this shape. Then we have the Open Lib button. If I press Open Lib, it will just open the library folder. So that's very simple. So if I press Open Lib, it will just open the library folder, so you can easily get to your libraries at any time. Then we have the Kill Blender button. If I press this one and I press OK, it will just kill Blender. That's very simple. And it doesn't matter if Blender is hanging or not, it will just kill Blender. So we are back. And you also see the Add Library button is orange unless you press it one time, and then at the next switch of the layer it will be painted in blue. Then you know, okay, I have used it. Then we have the Hide button. If I press the left button on Hide, quick button will just go away, and you can, until you drive over it with the mouse, then it will come back. So Hide, it's gone, and then it comes back. The next button is, you see, you have those tooltips. Sometimes you need them, sometimes they are nasty. So if you press the right button here on top, then you get on top one, and then the button bar will always be on top. And this means there will also be no tooltips, because they would be behind the button bar. So wherever you have the console window or other windows, the button bar will just be on top because you pressed on top on one. If I make it back on zero, then it can be behind some other windows. Otherwise, it will just be on top, which I use mostly. Then there is the fast button. So if I, for example, press Add Library, you see nothing. To show you what something, I must make space. Watch. I press Add Library. So, and you see it's in a fraction of a second. Try again. So in a fraction of a second, it's all been typed. So this is the fast mode. If I switch this to slow, the reason is just that you can better see what's happening. Then it looks like this. Then quick buttons will type it like you type it manually, in the same speed possibly, unless you are a very good typer. So it's going to take some time. So. Normally the slow mode was for debugging in early stages. It's possibly not even more needed. It's still there for that you can use it for whatever reasons it may be useful for. And you see, of course, what's being typed here. So that's the slow fast button. I make it fast. And then we have the final button is the end back button. With end, the button bar will just go away. Left mouse button. And with the right mouse button, which is back, he will go to the layer here, layer 3, that we were last, or back. So that is the back button. These are the special the system buttons. You cannot change the system buttons, but I think you could theoretically change button 20. Let me see. Yeah, button 20 is a normally defined button. It looks like this. And that's so in between system button and normal button, but you shouldn't change it. On the other side, what you see in button 20, here is how you register the library. And you also see another feature that is the lib feature, which will insert the path of where Quick Buttons itself is into this path, and then it goes into the Python variable and is later appended, so you can use the library. So this is explanation of the system buttons. So let's take a look at some of the special features. View at selected. So let's take this nice ball here. And now if I go to, for example, layer 4 and I choose button 18, but the version B, so I press the right mouse button, then I get this input box. And I can now enter some values, and these values will now be the input values for the for what we see here. So number of keyframes is set to 15, and number of rounds I will set to 2. And now let's see what happens. Because I set the number of rounds to 2, this will definitely take a while. So the baking took 12 seconds. Let's see what has happened. So we get some explosion effect here. So, but it's not about the effect for now. For now, it's about that we take a look on the button. So we are on layer 4 and we have button 18. This means if we go into the folder from layer 4, which is this one, and we take the button 18, and then you see here is the button text again. This is the text on the button. Then we have the tooltip text here. And immediately after the tooltip text, the tooltip text is always one line. And immediately after the tooltip text, we have the commands for the left button. This is this. And the command for the right button is after this here. And here comes another special feature. And this is the input feature. This is this line. So if you use this line, then you can write here the text that is displayed in the input box. And after this sign, you can give default values that are displayed. And then in the final command, you write these tags, input 1, input 2, until input whatever. And here, the numbers that you have given in the input box will be inserted into the command when it's written down here. Here, you will see here in the line, there are the numbers inserted that were used in the input box. So you have another feature, this is the input feature. So you can customize the commands anytime you use them. There are more such special features. So we have, for example, layer 2, button 17 or button 18. Let me take a look there. Layer 2, button 18, for example. Okay, what you see here is we have this file directive. And here you can choose a folder. And this folder is then assigned to a Python variable here. And then the images in this folder will be used for some sort of Python operation. As you can see here, the variable is then used as the first parameter in the library command. So you also have the possibility, for example, to use a file input box. We'll show you here. This is the file input box. And then here, please choose the file. You can choose a file and then something will happen with this file. And this will definitely take some time. So if you want to make Blender really busy, Quick Buttons is a good system for that. So in case you want to know how Quick Buttons is programmed, it's a smart package robot script, and the best is the script is included here. So here it is. I can open it and then you can see it and see exactly what's in the script. However, you may not be able to compile it without having the smart package robot programming system. But at least all the scripts are included and you can see what's in there. And I will show you how it runs. If I run here the smart package robot in the editor, you will see it starts up and Quick Button comes up. Then whatever I do, it will do the appropriate things here in the script. So for this general overview, let's just use a few functions of the button bar that are currently implemented that you can use. Press always first press button 20, add library, to connect the button bar and the library with the Blender console, Python console. So now somewhere in this scene there are some objects and I want them, so I go to layer 5. Layer 5 contains a lot of stuff about rotating objects, random move, random animation at keyframe. It's about keyframe stuff a little bit and camera keyframes, object keyframes. You can set here with just a click even without selecting the camera. So in this case I just press on button 2, the right mouse button, view at selected, and then I can see my object here. So, and I will drop them on the floor using the famous drop it add-on. And now let's use just some of the functions of the quick buttons. So let me go to layer 2. Layer 2 is sort of construction layer. So you have a lot of things that you can do with this. I will even add a new Cylinder, Icosphere is okay. So, but I will switch to Eevee for a moment, so I will work faster. So, somewhere is my Icosphere. I don't know where, so what do I do? Layer 5, view at selected. Here is my Icosphere, okay. I will drop it on the floor. Good. So now I will go to layer 2 and I will press, for example, button make quad button 13 number left button. And then I will say I want 5. 5 is okay for this. And what we get is we get a wall of 5 such objects here. Move them a bit together. So now you need to know the way they are produced. These are linked duplicates. So generally the multiplier in layer 2 always makes linked duplicates because they render faster. The problem with them is if you give one of them a color, all of them will have the same color. And I will show this to you. We are on layer 2. I can say press make random color. And you will see they always have the same color. So we have button 2, and button 2 makes convert linked duplicates to real objects. So I press button 2, and if I now make random color, any of these has another color. If I can press this more often until I have a combination that I really like. And even metal is possible if I want that. So how does it look with cycles?